Welcome to the Viewmasters. Batman, the Brave and the Bold, Episode 5. Day of the Dark Knight. My name is Eric.
My name is Joe.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Half expected you to say Farscape there for some reason. I'm three shows behind.
There was something other than Batman.
Yeah.
That was going to pop out. I'm not entirely sure what it was going to be. But I caught myself at the last minute.
Well done.
Yes, thank you.
Batman.
Batman.
I like this one.
It's a good one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like the first couple minutes of it probably more than I like the rest of it.
Well, sure. Because it's got your favorite characters.
Uh-huh.
The Green Lantern Corps.
That's right. Those weren't even the first couple minutes that I was referring to.
Oh, okay.
I actually mean the first couple minutes after the cold open.
Oh, okay.
That I like a lot.
So the second couple of minutes.
Yeah, okay, fine. Fuck you. And your semantics. But technically you're right. It is the second group of minutes.
Yeah, so the Green Lantern Corps is in the cold open.
Yes.
Heavily featuring Guy Gardner, with some appearances by Kilowog, and Chip.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the only one I recognized.
All right, the robot one is Stell, I believe.
Why is there a robot Green Lantern?
I don't know. There just is.
All right.
It's from a robot planet. A planet of robots.
But do robots have will and imagination?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
On this planet, they do.
Alrighty.
Robot will.
Robot will. And robot imagination.
Yes.
Yep.
What other Green Lanterns?
And the ability to overcome great fear.
Yes. That's right. Yeah. Robots don't know fear.
That's true.
To begin with, it is not in their programming.
That's why Daredevil's a robot.
That's right. Yes.
This is the man without fear.
This is the robot without fear.
Yep.
Which is every robot.
Yep.
I know there were other ones that I recognized, but I don't remember which ones they were.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter.
It does not matter.
Guy Gardner is the star here.
Yes.
Of the Green Lantern Corps.
As he should be.
All right. Yeah, you're right. He's the most interesting Green Lantern.
Yep. Yeah, so they fight this monster.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So then we back in the regular show. The aforementioned first 3 minutes that you truly enjoyed.
Yes.
There's a breakout out of prison. And Batman and his old pal Green Arrow are there to stop him.
Yeah, returning guest star.
Returning guest star, promoted.
Yes.
To feature guest star.
Promoted from cold open to his own full recurring splot. I don't know.
Splot?
Slot.
Okay.
What did I say?
Splot.
Splot, yes. Yeah. You know.
Yeah. A splot.
He's,
I get it.
Yeah.
Nope. Yep.
He's a guest slar.
Sure. He's a guest sklar?
Yes. Yes.
Like the Sklar brothers?
Exactly like the Sklar brothers. You mean Reggie Watts' adopted children?
Yes. Yes. Anywho.
But yeah, so Batman and Green Arrow arrive at the prison to stop the prison break.
Yes.
And they fight a lot of people in striped costumes.
Indeed.
And some of them are recognizable.
I recognized a few.
I recognized a few. Who did you recognize?
Well, I recognize definitely the ones that have already been on the show.
Yes.
Such as Kite Man.
Mm-hmm.
And Clock King.
Yes.
That's about it.
Is it really that it?
I think I recognized a couple of
them. Okay, good.
Like perhaps an egghead?
Uh-huh. Yeah? That's it? Really?
No, I recognized a couple.
Yeah, there was a King Tut.
Yep.
There's a bookworm.
Yep.
There's a Mad Hatter.
Indeed.
I liked, too, that when the Clock King got punched, so he's wearing the mask that he wore in his previous appearance, But then when he got punched, his face was clearly the guy who played Clock King on the Adam West Batman series.
That is, I think, what we should be leading with here.
Yes.
Is all the villains that are featured in this breakout are from the Adam West Batman series.
Yes. And I'm assuming that any of them that are do not have a visible gimmick are leftover henchmen.
Could be.
From the Adam West Batman series.
Did I see a false face in there?
You did see a false face in there.
That's what I thought.
You saw Shame in there.
Yep.
The Uncle Ben.
The cowboy hat.
Yes. Yeah. who else was there? Oh, Louis the Lilac was in there.
That one I don't know.
This is the guy with the purple hat with the flower in it.
There.
It's Milton Berle.
Ah.
Louis the Lilac.
I look forward to getting to that at some point.
Yeah. Season 3, you got a ways to go.
All right.
Siren was in there, and Nora Clavicle. They were the two women that that Green Arrow takes down with, like, a bola arrow.
Okay.
I think also Ma Parker was in there.
Okay.
There were a couple of older women.
The older woman here.
Yeah. I'm not sure who the other older... it might have been the Spider Lady. I think it was... No, Black Widow was her name. Yeah, not to be confused with the Avengers.
I believe that name is taken.
It is taken. You're right. so, yeah, that... that was delightful.
Yeah. So, so Batman and Green Arrow are rounding up these crooks,
mm-hmm.
preventing their escape, and they're not competing. But they're competing.
They're definitely competing. Yeah. It's like when you're playing a game with your friends, and you're like, no, we're just playing for fun, we're not keeping score.
Right.
In your head, you're totally keeping score.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because you need to know who wins.
Exactly. You gotta know who's better.
Exactly.
Yeah. And so when they're not keeping track, and totally keeping track,
mm-hmm.
They realize that they're tied.
Yeah.
And they see one lone runaway that they missed. And they both try to get him, but he waves off their weapons with some sort of magical spell.
Yes. He's magic.
And then transports them all out of prison. They're...
Well... Batman and Green Arrow.
And himself.
And himself, yes.
That's what I meant by them all.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah. Prisoners stay put.
Yes. Well, we nope.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I assume so.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I would assume the prison guards at this point would start doing their jobs.
I don't know. I think they killed all the prison guards.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, then,
Bookworm and King Tut and Egghead murdered dozens of innocent prison guards. In this scenario. This show is dark.
Yes. Yes, indeed.
But yeah, I mean, there is a big gaping hole in the prison wall, so they could escape, I guess.
Right?
I don't know.
And spoiler, when Batman and Green Arrow return... the hole's still there, and all the prisoners gone.
Yeah.
So,
I'm assuming that they escaped, and then they immediately get a report of a crime that they need to go stop.
Yep.
What if they get there, and it's False Face, and they're like, shit, we have to go catch all of those guys. It's like lame Nightfall. Can you imagine if Nightfall had Egghead?
Ah!
And King Tut. Oh, it would have been so great.
Probably would have been. it reminds me of... there always seems to be... It's usually a sci-fi or a supernaturally-based show that always has, like, a premise where the hero has to catch, like, a certain number, like, of bad guys or
yes.
whatever, or... He needs to find a certain number of artifacts in order to fulfill the prophecy. Or whatever.
Yeah, Pirates of Darkwater.
Sure.
13 Ghosts of Scooby-Doo.
Brimstone.
I don't know what that one is.
That was a television program on Fox in the mid to late 90s.
Okay.
I believe starring Peter Horton.
All right.
As a detective who was murdered and then brought back to life by the devil. To track down escaped souls from hell.
Nice.
The devil played by John Glover.
That's awesome. That's great.
That's always the one that sticks with me, because it was like 104 escaped souls or something like that. I was like, that series really thought it was going to go places.
Yeah.
It barely lasted a season.
Yeah, 13 Ghosts of Scooby-Doo. Scooby-Doo and Shaggy open Pandora's box and release 13 ghosts that they then have to capture over the course of the series.
Nice.
I think they only caught like 7 of them before the show ended.
Of course they did.
That is a show.
Because you're relying on Shaggy and Scooby-Doo to do anything.
Yeah.
Remotely worthwhile.
I think Daphne was there too.
Okay.
And then some little kid, I don't know.
What?
Not Scrappy-Doo, but just like a little kid. Thing. Yeah. But I, you know, I would like to see that that finished.
Sure.
In a comic.
Right.
I think that's, you know, perfect for comic adaptation and completion.
Or a waste of time.
Or a waste of time, maybe. What you call a waste of time, I call an enjoyable waste of time.
Alrighty. I pretty much think of anything Scooby-Doo related to be a waste of time.
Scooby-Doo Team-Up is a good comic.
There was one episode of Scooby-Doo Mysteries that I enjoyed.
Yeah, just one? There are two of them. Two. Yeah.
One or two.
With Batman and Robin.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, there's two of them.
Yeah. Maybe the one with Don Adams.
Yeah, that one's great.
Maybe the one with the Adams family, too.
Yeah.
Pretty much anything related to Adam.
Yeah, Adam West.
Adam West.
Don Adams.
Don Adams and the Adams family.
Don Adams family.
The Don Adams West family.
Yeah. I like it. So Batman and Green Arrow are teleported by a random wizard prisoner.
Yes.
To who knows where.
Right. Or when.
Or when. Whoa. Inspector Spacetime. The question is, who knows when we are? Yes, they are transported through time to 5th century England.
Yes.
And it turns out that the wizard convict is Merlin.
Yeah. What did he do to get thrown in what I would assume is Blackgate Prison?
Yeah. I don't know that he was actually a prisoner.
He was in a prison outfit.
He was in a prison outfit.
And he was escaping.
Actually, at first I thought it was Morlun, the Legion of Superheroes villain. Is that Morlun? Is that who I'm thinking of?
Sounds like a
the wizard guy.
Felix Faust.
Not Felix Faust. Morlun. Oh, I feel like I'm getting that name wrong. But when they're in the past and he puts on his purple cloaks, he looked like the time trapper.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
that's what made me think of it.
Right.
Mordru. Mordru is what I'm thinking of. Yeah. Morlun is the villain of the current Amazing Spider-Man storyline, Spider-Verse.
Oh, okay. So I knew that name. It sounded familiar.
Yeah.
Sounds like a wizardy name.
It does. Yeah. Yeah. No, it's just a guy who eats spider people.
Okay.
Yeah. But yeah, I thought that was more
true. J. Michael Straczynski.
That's right. J. Michael Straczynski also eats spider people.
Yeah.
That's what you were saying, right?
Oh.
Okay. But yeah, I definitely thought that was Mordru or the Time Trapper. But it wasn't. It was Merlin. I'm just too skeptical for my own good.
The Merlin?
I guess.
The historical figure?
Sure. Was the historical Merlin a wizard? Or, oh, not the archer Merlin. Is that who you're talking about?
No. I'm talking about the historical wizard.
Then yes.
Yeah.
It's the Merlin.
Yeah. Merlin the magician.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And why are you clarifying this way?
Just because he's a historical figure. And yeah. Not fictional at all.
Okay.
Like Jesus. Also a historical
not
figure.
Not a direction I expected this show to go.
But you have been paying attention.
I guess not. yes, the historical figure Merlin.
Yes.
of Camelot times.
Yes, not Tommy Merlin.
No, not Tommy Merlin. Not
John Barrowman.
John Barrowman. I wish it was John Barrowman. I like John Barrowman.
Who doesn't?
Dumb people.
It's true. So Batman and the Hood are in ancient times.
Yep, they are.
And Tommy Merlin wants them to fight King Arthur.
That's I'm not paying attention. No. Okay, to clarify, it's Batman and Green Arrow.
Don't know who that is.
He's the Hood guy.
Okay.
Okay. It's historical Merlin, not Tommy Merlin.
Okay.
Not Roger Merlin or whatever. Whatever. I don't remember his name. John Barrowman.
Mr. Merlin.
Mr. Merlin. Arthur Merlin? No. I don't think so.
You're thinking of Aquaman.
I am thinking of Aquaman, that's right. Arthur Curry. No, they have been brought back in time because Morgan Le Fay has turned everybody to stone.
Yep. Or monsters.
Or monsters.
She's taken over England.
And Merlin went searching for someone who would be worthy to wield Excalibur.
He found Thor.
The UK Marvel team. Excalibur. They need to find someone who can pick up Kitty Pryde, Lockheed, Nightcrawler, Captain Britain, Rachel Summers, Megan? Was that it?
Yep.
Yes! Somebody can pick up all seven of those characters at the same time.
Yep. And just throw them.
That's right. Speedball special. With the whole team. Merlin went searching through time to find someone worthy of taking Excalibur out of the stone.
Yep.
Did not find Thor.
No, because Thor's already got his worthy weapon.
Yeah, he's got his axe.
Yep. Yornbjorn.
Yornbjorn. Bort.
Mahojin.
And instead he found either Batman or Green Arrow. They were apparently both in the frame at the same time when his crystal ball showed it up. So he's like, I'll just take both of them.
Yeah.
One of them probably is it.
Yeah, sure. It's probably Batman.
It's probably, yeah.
It's his show.
Yeah. Definitely.
So
Green Arrow sucks.
Huh?
Green Arrow sucks.
Yeah, he does. He's not worthy of anything.
He's a dick.
He's just an ass.
Yeah.
He's just an ass who likes to rip off better heroes.
That's right. With his Arrow car.
Oh, the Arrow car.
Yes, we did talk about the Arrow car before. It does make its first appearance in this episode. It's a hideous car.
It's a giant arrow.
It's terrible.
It's dumb.
It basically looks like a big T.
Yeah, it's like a really dumb Indy car, but painted green and with a pointy hood.
Yeah, yeah. He has a tiny penis.
Yeah.
Super tiny.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you'd probably say the same about Batman.
That's true. That's true.
I mean, the Batmobile is...
It's pretty large, too. Yeah. It's just not as obviously phallic.
No, yeah. He covers it up well.
He does.
He's got a lot more bush around his...
Oh, gross. Why? Why do you do this? We're having a perfectly nice time.
I can't help myself. I am mentally 12.
I know. Me too, buddy. Me too.
All right.
So Batman, it is assumed by Merlin, is the one who is worthy of picking up Excalibur, to Green Arrow's protestations.
I didn't know he was Protestant.
He's Protestant, yeah. Yeah. He carries a copy of the 95 Theses in his back pocket.
95 Theses?
I think it's 95 Theses. That's exactly what I said. Yeah, Martin Luther was so, Martin Luther King Jr. was so angry that he nailed 95 feces to a church door, and it was gross.
No wonder they killed him.
So they fight Morgan Le Fay, and Morgan Le Fay's servant happens to be Jason Blood, better known as Etrigan the Demon.
What?
Right? Yeah.
Yeah.
In King Arthur times, Etrigan was there.
Yeah, he was.
That's where he comes from.
That is where he comes from.
So it's not a surprise that he was there.
I was happy to see him.
Me too.
Because I like that character for reasons I can't explain.
Yeah? Is it because he's awesome?
It could be that.
Yeah.
Hey.
Yeah. He looks really good in this show.
Yeah, he does.
You know, the Kirby designs and style really lend themselves well to animation.
They do. That's why Kirby was a genius.
Yes.
Surprised. I guess he did have quite a few cartoons that he worked on, though.
Yeah, he worked on Thundar.
Yeah.
Is that one?
Yeah. I believe so.
That's the only one I know about off the top of my head.
There we go.
Yeah. Thundar the Barbarian.
Yeah.
Oopla the Mock.
Everyone else just ripped him off.
Yes. Yeah. Like He-Man.
Yes.
He-Man is basically a Thundar ripoff.
Yeah. You know, the Masters of the Universe movie is, originally, sort of started out as a fourth world movie.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, I didn't know that.
Yep.
Wow.
And then, the director of it basically, you know, once he realized he couldn't do a fourth world movie, you know, he wound up doing He-Man.
Yeah.
He, tried to get as much Kirby into it as he possibly could and basically dedicated the movie to him.
That's awesome. Yeah. That's really cool.
I may be wrong in all of that, but there's a sliver of truth somewhere in there.
I'll look it up.
There is a connection between Jack Kirby and the Masters of the Universe movie starring Dolph Lundgren.
I can see that, like the cosmic key that Gwildor runs around with. It looks very much like a Kirby creation.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah. You know what? I like that movie.
I do too. Yeah. I like a young Courtney Cox.
Yeah, I'm alright with her.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Frank Langella is awesome.
Frank Langella is great.
Yeah.
And that weird-eyed chick that played the Sorceress.
Yeah.
Not the Sorceress. Evelyn.
Oh, okay.
Can't remember her name.
I can't either.
She looks like Kirstie Alley, but she has crazy, crazy eyes.
Kirstie Alley.
Kirstie Alley.
Now. Time-traveling Kirstie Alley.
Anyway,
yeah, Batman and Green Arrow fight the demon.
Yeah, and he rhymes.
And he rhymes, speaks. Yes.
Which is awesome.
Yeah.
And
it's not annoying about it.
No.
I appreciate that.
Yeah. Because, sometimes I read some comics when he's appears, and the rhyming gets obnoxious.
Yeah.
When you try to read it.
It's just really forced sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes. It's just a good balance here.
Definitely.
Kudos to episode writer J.M. DeMatteis.
Yes. Well done.
Yes. Famous comic writer.
Yeah.
Current writer of Justice League 3000.
Yeah. Etrigan was in the most recent issue of that.
Was he?
Yeah.
I have not read the book.
Sorry if that's a spoiler.
That's all right.
Okay. Not a big spoiler.
Yeah,
I don't think so.
Yeah.
There's bigger spoilers.
We'll keep those
to myself. I will keep those to myself. Right. But yeah, he wrote, he's written a lot of animation.
He wrote
a few episodes of the Justice League.
Yep.
And other stuff.
Yep.
So, yeah. Good to see him.
Indeed.
But yeah, so they fight, and then Morgan Le Fay, they defeat Etrigan. And then Morgan Le Fay appears and takes control of Batman.
Yep. And gives him a bit of a medieval upgrade.
Yes.
With some badass armor.
It was really cool.
Some badass armor.
Stop it. I really like that the Batmobile... and the armor and, like, all of his vehicles are black and red.
Yeah.
The 60s Batmobile color scheme makes my heart happy.
Yeah. Is that how you felt about Batman Beyond, too?
I hadn't really thought of it, but he is black and red, yeah. No, I hadn't really thought of it for Batman Beyond, but yeah, that makes sense.
What about Nightwing's current redesign?
Not so much.
Well, I guess his current redesign is just clothes.
Yeah. Yeah, because he's just a spy guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, new 52 Nightwing?
Yeah.
Yeah, fine, whatever.
Yeah.
I like the black and blue more.
I like the black and blue better, and finger stripes.
Yes. Yes. Indeed.
And the mullet.
Not so much the mullet.
Actually, you know, I really like the disco outfit.
Yeah. It's a great costume.
It is. And I also like the other one that he wore between the two.
Yeah, was it the Tom Grummett designed one?
Yeah, with the wings.
Yeah, that one was cool.
Yeah. I like Nightwing.
Yeah, I like Nightwing too.
Have you been reading Grayson?
I have not.
Okay.
I don't really care for Tim Seeley.
I'm okay with Tim Seeley.
Yeah.
He's a nice guy.
That's cool.
Gave me a free Blue Beetle sketch once.
Nice.
Yeah.
Is it a good book?
I don't know. I haven't read it.
Oh, okay.
That's what I was asking you about.
Oh, okay. I've read the first two trades of Revival.
Yeah.
Which is not bad.
I like Revival.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's all I have to say. Okay. Yeah, it's not bad.
Yeah.
I like the art a lot.
The art's good.
I like Mike Norton.
Yeah. I've never quite really latched on to like Hack Slash or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, I mean, I think Dick Grayson as a super spy is an interesting journey.
Yeah.
Since, you know, Dan DeVito just seemingly wants him out of the picture entirely.
Yeah.
You know, if you have to force him into a place where he doesn't belong, that's I guess, better than just not existing.
I agree. Wally West. Actually, no, I'd rather that Wally West just didn't exist at this point.
Where he currently is?
Yeah.
Or the current version of Wally West?
Yeah, the current version of Wally West.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because he's black.
No, because he's a terrible character.
Oh, okay.
Has nothing to do with being black.
I haven't heard anything about him since they announced that he returned.
Yeah.
And when I say returned, was completely reintroduced as an entirely different character.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was dumb.
Okay.
Yeah, so Evil Batman.
Evil Batman! And cool armor.
And cool armor. And, I guess I forgot to mention before this, they went to the mountain where Excalibur lives.
Yep.
In stone. That's a big mountain that's shaped like a sword.
Yep.
Totally inconspicuous.
Well, you know, who's going to think to look for a sword in a mountain shaped like a sword?
Exactly.
I mean, you know, hide in plain sight.
That's right. Yes, it's like the key to the Fortress of Solitude.
Right.
I guess it doesn't matter if people know where the sword is.
Right.
Because no one can pick it up anyway.
Exactly.
So that's all right. I take it back.
And also, you know, it's kind of hard to get to.
It is kind of hard to get to.
You have to defeat two giant ogres.
Yeah.
And then you have to wait for the giant rock stairs to form so that you can climb up it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you have to be really good at hopping between giant rock stairs.
Right. I mean, so no one's going to really want to do that.
That's
all.
True.
I mean, that's just tedious. And that's also proving that they're just not worthy.
Yeah. That's right. Only he who is worthy, or she,
yeah.
Will take the time to make that journey.
Exactly.
That's totally fair. But yeah, then Morgan Le Fay takes over Batman, and then Batman goes up and goes to get the sword.
Yep. And then Merlin reluctantly sort of just kind of hopes maybe Green Arrow will be able to stop him.
Yeah.
Nobody has faith in Ollie.
Nope. He sucks.
Yeah. So he fights Batman and then dies immediately.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Batman knocks him off a cliff.
Yep. The end.
The end. That's the death of Green Arrow.
Yep. And then he goes to pick up Excalibur because he is worthy,
mm-hmm.
and claims it, and Morgan Le Fay then spreads evil throughout all of the world with the power of Excalibur.
Uh-huh, exactly.
Yep.
That's exactly what happened.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's not what happens.
That is not what happens. Turns out Batman, not exactly worthy.
No. Yeah. That sucks.
I guess
for Batman.
Yeah. There was some other stuff that happened in there in between.
There was. Yeah. So Green Arrow apparently dies.
Yeah.
And then Merlin uses a magic ball. Like a ball of magic to release Batman. Apparently it's that easy.
You know, it's magic. There are no rules.
That's true. It doesn't matter how it works.
That is what we learned from Spider-Man comics.
That's right.
Yep.
J. Michael Straczynski.
Yep.
Well-known eater of spider people. An occasional hack writer.
Yep.
But yeah, so Batman is released, tries to lift Excalibur, is unable to do so.
Yep.
Shock.
Merlin shows up, he has freed Jason Blood from the enchantment, as Batman is also free from
yes.
the enchantment as well.
Everybody's free.
Everybody's free, and Morgan turns into a giant dragon.
Mm-hmm. Like you do.
Sure. then immediately turns the demon Merlin and Batman into stone.
Mm-hmm.
Well, not Batman.
Yeah, not Batman, but the demon and Merlin for sure.
Yep.
And then turns her sights on Batman.
Yes. But then suddenly she gets shot in the face with an arrow.
What?
Yeah.
There are other archers? Does Robin Hood show up?
Yep.
Robin Hood's from King Arthur times, right?
Uh-huh.
I don't know. Hawkeye. Merlin. Tarantula. Taskmaster probably uses a bow and arrow
probably,
sometimes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Amazo.
Because he replicates all the powers.
Speedy.
Speedy. Arsenal.
Arsenal, yes. Red Arrow. Three different versions of Roy Harper appear.
Connor Osh.
Yes!
Don't
even joke.
That is who I assumed we were talking about when we said Hawk Guy.
That's... Bravo. Bravo. No, it's a Green Arrow. He's still alive.
Yeah.
And he saunters over to Excalibur and triumphantly does not pull it from the stone.
Nope.
Because he's not worthy either.
Nope. But then Batman decides that maybe together...
Yes.
They're both worthy.
Teamwork.
Teamwork indeed.
And it works.
And it does work. And they free Excalibur... Batman immediately tosses it to Green Arrow, who then shoots Excalibur like an arrow through the heart of the dragon, Morgan Le Fay.
Yeah.
Because that's awesome.
That's totally awesome. Like, shooting a sword is absolutely exactly like shooting an arrow.
Yep. There is not any bit of difference whatsoever.
Do you think that Green Arrow practices shooting other non-arrow things with his bow in his free time?
I'm sure.
Like, oh, this table leg might come in handy.
You know, it's like...
Twang.
It's like Henry Rollins, you know, of Black Flag and the Rollins Band, and also the voice of Kilowog in the Green Lantern animated movie.
Yes.
You know, when he goes out on tour with his band, they practice in a very small room with no air conditioning for, like, 16 hours at a time.
Yikes.
So that way they are fully prepared when they're on stage because the conditions are just going to be better than that. And I think that's what Green Arrow does.
That's really smart.
He is, like, shooting logs with his bow and arrow.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know? Just picking up weird, unwieldy, heavy objects and just trying to shoot them. And that's how he practices.
The other bows.
Shooting other bows.
Shooting his hat. He's probably like, what if I need to use my empty quiver?
Right. What about this feather that I have stuck in my hat?
Yes. Macaroni! That's what he says as he fires it.
Yeah. Here's a carburetor for the aero car. What if I need to shoot the aero car?
What if I get a flat tire and need to shoot that?
What about this crowbar?
That'd probably work really well.
Probably.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. So yeah, they defeat Morgan Le Fay. Everyone is turned back from stone to normal. And then the Etrigan just takes off. Because screw humans.
Pretty much.
Basically.
Yeah.
And then Merlin says that he's going to take Batman and Green Arrow to meet King Arthur. Yeah. So that they can be knighted.
Knights.
Yeah.
Niggets.
That's nice. But then he overhears them arguing over who won.
Yep.
Like who did better. And decides they're not worthy.
Nope.
To be knights.
Batman and Green Arrow are just a couple of rich assholes.
That's right. They really are. They could probably buy a knighthood in present day.
Probably.
And they're not even British.
Nope.
Good enough.
So they return home, and they realize that they're still tied. But then Batman hears a crime go.
He sure does. There's a crime in Starling City.
Yep. And they're going to race to see who can get there first.
They are.
And we're done.
The end. Yeah. This one was fine.
It was fine.
I liked the prison break the most.
Yeah. Yeah. I liked Armored Batman.
That was cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, very cool visual.
I could pretty much always do without King Arthur time anything.
Yeah, magic, really, I'm not that into.
Depends on the magic.
Yeah.
Like if it was Dr. Fate and Zatanna or whatever, I'm good with that.
Yeah.
But you throw Merlin and Morgan Le Fay, any variation of that, I'm just done with.
Yeah.
Yeah. Seen it a lot.
Mm-hmm.
In Marvel and DC.
Other episodes of Justice League.
Yep.
That we've already watched and talked about for this podcast.
Yep. I believe they even had the demon in them, too.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you for listening to The Viewmasters. You can subscribe to the show directly at view.guttertrash.net or at iTunes and leave us a review. Visit view.guttertrash.net for email information and links to Facebook and Twitter. We'll see you next time on The Viewmasters.